This is my version of a 3D zoetrope, a lily flower opening and closing in a loop. My mom has always been a huge fan of lilies, and there's always a bouquet of them inside her apartment. And I've been meaning to do an animation with 3D prints for quite some time, and when I saw the potential to incorporate the flowers into this, I knew I had my design. Well, I think that's mom's birthday present sorted for this year. Well, actually, birthday and Christmas. Hi, my name is Spun with Holocreators, and today I want to talk about 3D zoetropes. The concept is actually really simple, and it works like this. You take a rotating table and you arrange a set of 3D prints in a circle around it. In my case, it was 15 different prints of the lily, and each print is differing slightly from the next. So mine were in different stages of the bloom. And then you take a strobe light and flash it on this rotating table. And the outcome is, well, take a look for yourselves. I know what you're thinking. You're thinking, Svan, you must be a genius to come up with something like this. And you're right. But there's also a lot of incredible technology involved into the production. So how did I do it? Well, first I had to decide on a suitable base model. I experimented with a rose and even with a sunflower before finally settling on a lily. The problem is that they have so many petals. A rose has around 15 and a sunflower about 60 to 70 because it's just a massive yellow show-off. But the lily just has 6 because it's humble and modest like me. Plus, it's way easier to animate. And my mom doesn't like sunflowers, so it was a win-win. I bought a closed lily flower and put it on my desk, anxiously waiting for it to open. For a very long time nothing happened, but then it went rather quickly. One morning it started and it went from closed to open in about 20 hours. During these 20 hours I made 8 separate 3D scans from the lily flower using the photogrammetry scanning technique. I covered that in a different video. The idea is to take photographs of the flower from different angles and then put it inside a 3D software, and this calculates a 3D model from it. And here are a few views of the raw 3D scans from the flower. Then I took these 8 different scans and gave them to my 3D animation colleagues, and they put it inside an animation software and took the scans only as a reference and rebuilt the model inside the software. And what we ended up with was a looping animation of the flower closing and opening. And then from this animation, we extracted 15 separate models, which we got printed and arranged in a circle and glued to a circular wooden blackboard. At night, we went to a playground and mounted this blackboard to that round thing kids used to spin around. I think it's called a carousel. And then using a strobe light, we flashed onto it and we synced the flashes with the turning speed of the carousel. And the animation was finally complete. And all it took was a huge amount of work, a ton of money, and a police warning for being on a kid's playground at night. Well, that's it for this week. Thanks for watching. If you like, please subscribe and see you next time. Bye-bye.